This is the exact workflow I use to completely automate my Instagram posting without any third-party tools. And the results? I went from 0 to 43,000 followers in just 6 months. Let me show you a quick demo. Watch this. I'm executing the workflow now. It automatically pulls data from Google Sheets, generates an SEO-optimized caption using AI, and uploads the video, all on autopilot. Now, let's check Instagram. And there we go. It's uploaded successfully. In this video, I'll walk you through the entire process, step by step, so you can build this workflow from scratch. Even if you're a complete beginner, you'll be able to follow along and set it up yourself. So, let's dive in. First, let me show you the resources I have. Here, I have 4 videos ready. I also have a Google Sheet, which has 3 columns. The first one is file name. Here, I've added the names exactly the same as the video file names. You can see WhatsApp AI agent, Google Gemini API, and so on. The only thing you need to remember when naming your video files is, don't add any spaces in between. For example, if you check here, you'll see website AI agent, which has spaces between the words. That makes it a little difficult for us to implement in our N8N workflow. To avoid that, when naming your video files, just add an underscore or a hyphen instead, like this, to remove spaces. And make sure you add the exact same video file name in the Google Sheet as well. The next column is outline, which is a single line description of the video topic. We'll use this outline to create an SEO optimized Instagram caption using AI. The next column is status. Whenever a new video is posted, it will automatically update the status to posted. So during the next execution, it picks the next row. All right, now let's start building our N8N workflow. Open your N8N dashboard and create a new workflow. First, we're adding a schedule trigger to set up when we want to execute our workflow and publish the video. Here, select schedule trigger. I'm planning to execute this workflow every day. So set the trigger interval as days and set days between triggers to 1. Next, we have to select trigger at hour, meaning the time you want it to run. So let me select 9 a.m. Then we can choose trigger at minute. For example, if you want to execute it at 9:30, just set the minute to 30. You can add multiple triggers by tapping on add rule. Let's select 6:10 p.m. You can add more if needed. Now, back to the canvas. Next, let's add a Google Sheets node to pull the video details. Click on the plus icon and search for sheet. Select Google Sheets and set the action as get rows in sheet. First, we need to connect our Google account. If you don't know how to connect it, we've created a detailed video on that. You can find the link in the video description. Next, choose the document. In my case, it's named Reels Automation, and select the sheet as sheet 1. Now, we need to add a filter. Whenever a new video is uploaded, we'll update its status as posted. So, for the next execution, we want to take only the next row that isn't posted yet. We can achieve this by adding a filter. Tap on Add Filter and select the column status. Keep the value empty. This way, it'll take only the row where the status column is empty. Now tap on Add option and enable Return Only First Matching Row. Currently, it would take all the matching rows where status is empty, but we only need 1 matching row per execution. By enabling this, it will take just 1 at a time. Let's execute this step. And it's done. Here we got 1 matching row, WhatsApp AI agent.mp4. Next, we're adding an AI agent to create an SEO optimized Instagram caption. This step is optional. If you already have a ready-made caption available in your Google Sheet, you can use that directly. Otherwise, just follow along with these steps. Just tap on the plus icon and search AI agent. Simply select it and change the source for the prompt to define below. Here, just add video topic, then drag and drop the outline string like this. Now click on add option and select system message. Here we can add some instructions for our AI agent. Let's add, you are a social media expert who writes engaging and SEO optimized Instagram captions. Create a short and catchy caption for the given video topic. Make sure the tone sounds natural and appealing to the audience. Add 2 highly relevant hashtags at the end that fit the topic. Perfect. Let's close this. Next, we have to add a chat model. This is literally like a brain for our AI agent. We have multiple options available, like Google, Gemini, OpenAI, etc. Let me choose Google Gemini, which is free. We've already created a video on that, and you can find the link in the video description. Choose the model as Gemini 2.5 Flash. Back to Canvas. And now let's execute the step. It's running. Done. Let's open it. And here we can see the Instagram caption with two hashtags, made by AI. Next, we can add the Facebook Graph API node to upload the videos. But before that, we have to upload our videos on an online cloud platform. Facebook's API doesn't allow direct uploads from platforms like Google Drive or OneDrive. It requires a public video link. For that, let's use Cloudinary, which is a free platform where we can upload up to 25 gigabytes of files. Just click on Sign Up for free and create an account. I already have one, so let me sign in. Once done, just go to the Assets section. Here you may see some default files. Don't mind that. Just go to the Folder section and let's create a new folder. Name it as Reels and click Save. Open the folder and now we are ready to upload our videos. But if we upload them right now, it will change the video file names and they won't match with the file names we have in our Google Sheet. To avoid that, just go to Settings, Upload, and here we can see an upload preset. Click on the three dots and tap Edit. Here we have to select the option. Use the file name of the uploaded file as the public ID. And turn, append a unique suffix of. Turn, use the initial asset folder path, on. Click on Save. And now the file renaming issue must be fixed. Now go back to Assets, Folders, open the Reel folder and upload your videos. It's done. Let me open one video. Click on the three dots, copy the URL, choose copy original URL and open it. The first part of the link will be the same for every video. The only change will be the file name, which we can dynamically fetch from our Google Sheet. Now go back to the N8N dashboard and let's add the Facebook Graph API node. Just tap on the plus icon, search Facebook and select Facebook Graph API. First, we have to connect our Facebook business account. It's a 5-minute process and it's easy. Just follow the steps. This is the Instagram account I'm using for this tutorial. Just keep in mind that we can't connect a normal private or personal account. We need to convert our Instagram account to a professional account. To do that, just click on the three dots, then go to Settings. Here, scroll down and select Account Type and Tools. Now tap on Switch to Professional Account. Here you can select Creator or Business, depending on your preference. Click Next, choose the page category, click Done, and tap on Continue. It's done. Next, we have to connect our Instagram with a Facebook page. For that, just go to facebook.com and log in with your Facebook account. Then go to facebook.com/pages. You can connect an existing page or even create a new one. Just enter a Facebook page name, choose the category, and add a bio if needed. Then click on Create Page. It will ask you to finish setting up the page. You can add the details or skip for now. The Facebook page is ready. Now just tap on Professional Dashboard, tap on Linked Accounts, and select Instagram. Connect account. Connect your account by simply logging into your Instagram page. While connecting, it will automatically create a Facebook business portfolio, meaning a business account. Just tap on Continue, enter the verification code you receive, and here we go. Our Instagram account has been successfully connected with our Facebook page. Next, we have to get the access token. For that, go to business.facebook.com and log in with your Facebook account. Once done, you'll see the business portfolio we recently created. Now, on the left side, just tap on Settings. When we check the Pages section, we can see the Facebook page. And under the Instagram account section, we can see our Instagram account as well. Now go to Apps. And here we have to create an app in order to get the access token. Click on Create a new app ID. This will redirect us to developer.facebook.com. Tap on Create app. Here, we have to enter an app name and email address. Let's say RealFlow. You can put any name here. Click Next. Here we have to choose the use cases. Just tap on Others, select Other again and click Next. Choose the app type as Business, then click Next. Now choose the same business portfolio and click on Create App. You may have to log in again with Facebook to verify this. Now, Our app is created. We don't have to do anything extra here. Go back to business.facebook.com and refresh the page. And here, the newly created app is listed. Now go to System Users and click on Add. Simply accept this, enter a system username, and choose the system user role as admin. Tap on Create System User. Oh, there's an error. Let's change this to Employee. It's done. Now tap on Assign Assets. Select the Facebook page and set the permission as Full Control. Go to Apps, select the app, and again choose Full Control. Now select the Instagram account, set the permission as Full Control, and hit Assign Assets. It's done. Let's refresh the page. And here are the assets details. Now click on Generate Token. Select the app and set the expiration as 60 days or never. Here we have to choose 6 permissions: Business Management, Instagram Basic, Instagram Content Publish, Pages, Show List, Pages Manage Posts, and Pages Read Engagement. Now click on Generate Token, and here we go. We've got the access token. Just copy this and go back to the N8N dashboard. Paste it here, click Save, and our Facebook business account has been connected successfully. Close this. Here, select the post URL as default and change the HTTP request method to post because we are uploading something. Next, choose the Graph API version as default or latest. In this column, we have to add a unique ID, which every Facebook or Instagram page has. To get that, just go back to business.facebook.com. Go to Instagram accounts, and here you can see the ID. Just copy this, go back to N8N, and paste it here. Next, in the Edge column, add media. Now click on Add option and select Query Parameters. Then tap on Add Parameter. In the Name column, add video underscore URL. In the Value column, we have to add the public video link, which we got from Cloudinary. So just go back to Cloudinary. And this is how our video link looks like. Let's open it in a new tab. As I mentioned earlier, we just have to copy the first part of the link without the file name, which will be the same for all the videos we upload. Now go back to the dashboard, make this as expression, and paste the link here. Next, we have to add the file name at the end. For that, just click on the Google Sheet node here and drag and drop the file name string like this. When we check here, it will be exactly like the video link. And I hope now you got the logic. We have to add 2 more parameters. In the Name column, add caption. In the Value column, just drag and drop the AI agent output string, like this. Add 1 more parameter. Set the name as media type. Add the value as Reels, in capital letters. And here, instead of default, we have to choose the latest version, 23.0. Perfect. Now let's execute the step. It's done, and we got an ID here. The video isn't uploaded yet. This step only creates the post container. We're just one step away now. Let's add 1 more Facebook node to actually publish the video. Here, select the HTTP request method as post. Set the Graph API version as 23. In the node column, we have to add our Instagram unique ID, just like before. So go to the previous node, copy the ID, and paste it here. In the Edge column, add media publish. Scroll down and click on Add option, then select Query Parameters. Tap on Add Parameter. In the Name field, add creation underscore ID. And in the Value field, just drag and drop the ID string, like this. Now, let's execute the step. It's done. Let's check our Instagram. Simply refresh the page. And here we go. Our reel is uploaded with the caption and hashtags. It's working perfectly. Back to the dashboard. Now we have to add 2 more steps. When you test this in production, you'll notice the second Facebook node runs immediately after the first one. But sometimes that causes an error because Facebook's server takes a few seconds to update the container ID after it's created. To fix that, we'll add a small wait node between the 2 steps, just to give the API a few seconds to process before we upload the video. Set the wait amount as 60 seconds. Back to the canvas. Open this node, go to Settings, and enable retry on fail. Set the wait between tries as 5 seconds. So even after 60 seconds, if it fails, it will retry 3 more times with a 5-second delay. That makes it perfect for this workflow. Now, we have to add a Google Sheet node to update the video status. That way, it will take the next row for the next execution. Tap on the plus icon, search sheet, and select it. Set the action as update row in sheet. Select the same document and the same sheet. Set the column to match on as row number. And here, just drag and drop the row number string, like this. Delete the file name and outline fields. In the status field, just add posted. Let's execute the step. It's done. And in the Google Sheet, it updated the status. Now, for the next execution, it will take the next row, which is the next empty one. Now, it's time to do the final test. Let's execute the workflow. It takes the data from Google Sheets, creates an SEO-optimized Instagram caption, creates a Facebook container with our video, waits for 60 seconds, and now it uploads the video and updates the status on Google Sheets. Let's check Instagram. And here we go again. It's uploaded successfully. And yes, it also updated the status on Google Sheets. Now, let's activate the workflow so it will trigger automatically at the time we set in the schedule trigger. One more thing, just go to settings and make sure you've selected the correct time zone. Otherwise, it might trigger at a different time. Okay, that's it. I've tried my best to explain everything as clearly as I can. You can download the Flow.json file from the link in the video description. Try it out and let me know in the comments if you have any doubts. I'll be happy to answer and make sure it's truly helpful for you. So that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. We'll be uploading more AI and automation tutorials in the coming days. So don't forget to like and subscribe. It's totally free. Until next time, it's me, Rajiv, signing off.